Everybody knows about that hungry feeling encountered after not eating for a while and how to fix it. But why do we need to eat the things that we eat in order to survive? As consumers, we aren't like plants, which produce their own food and need to eat in order to acquire energy. Therefore, humans rely on the food chain that starts with photosynthetic plants that harness the energy of the sun to synthesize sugars. The energy from these sugars is either taken in directly in the form of fruits and vegetables, or indirectly from eating animals that eat the plants. We use the energy to carry out everything from maintaining organ function to doing physical activity. However, as omnivores, we have also evolved to eat a varied diet. The United States Department of Agriculture outlines a pyramid of foods part of a complete diet, starting from the largest portion of grains and ascending into smaller portions of meats, veggies, fruits, dairy, and fats. Humans cannot live properly with missing one or more of these key areas, unless a substitute is eaten. For example, complete proteins vital for muscle growth are found in meats, and vitamins, important for the immune system and other processes, are mainly found in fruits and veggies. A condition known as scurvy involves a lack of vitamin C from fruits and veggies and affected poorly nourished sailors that ended up with teeth falling out and other problems. Another condition, known as pellagra, involves a lack of niacin, often found in meats, which causes hair loss, swelling, and red lesions on the skin. The fact that we are omnivores dates back to natural selection. To put natural selection simply, it's survival of the fittest. There were more advantages of receiving nutrients from eating both plant and animal material, so humans evolved as omnivores. Early humans ate lean protein, unprocessed vegetables, and fruit. Dr. Mann notes in his article, A Review of Human Diet from an Evolutionary Perspective, that we have evolved to eat such unprocessed foods and used to have a high protein, high fat, and low carb diet. Many call this the paleo diet. He adds that foods that are very energy dense, such as sugar and refined grains, were not part of the foods we evolved eating and contribute to chronic obesity and diabetes. So what happens if someone stops consuming any type of food? First off, the body will start to deplete the glycogen storages in its liver. Once that is depleted, within a couple of days, the body will revert to breaking down fat in some muscle for fuel. Eventually, the fat being used for fuel will run out and the body will revert to breaking down much more muscle. Once this happens, death results from loss of organ function. We all need to carry out functions in our bodies, but unfortunately, many die every day from starvation.